Love is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Fully assembled. You can accept students tomorrow.
Thanks a lot there.
Sure thing.
Uncle Chow, come over. Kimura, Blair, take a look. I revised the logo of our Kung Fu school. Look, look at the sign. Can you guess what it really means?
The meaning is in those two lines.
The style of no style. No limits as your limit. That's the philosophy of Jun Fan Kung Fu.
Bruce. Your understanding of Kung Fu is at the philosophical level. That makes it even more precious. Do you think you could explain the meaning of those two lines to us?
Sure. Lao Tzu said that in the order of the universe, from nothing comes everything. And something creates everything. Over here, nothing is Taoism. Taoism, by itself, creates something. Lao Tzu uses Taoism. And by using Taoism, he describes the natural order of the universe. Also, another Greek philosopher named Socrates said that we should forget about all the rules we know to remove doubt so that we can cultivate the fragrant flowers of ideology.
That's terrific, Bruce. You've managed to merge martial arts with philosophy. Amazing.
Let's go back to work.
I've always liked Chinese Kung Fu, and I've been looking for a school that would teach me martial arts. I like your school. It's great.
Oh, you may proceed.
Hi there.
Hi there. Name, please?
Jim.
Oh, you may get your uniform. Oh, wait, please. Why are you all guys? All I see are guys. All guys. All guys. All guys. Finally, we have a girl. This is so great. You know, I'm so glad we finally have a female student here for a change. Reminds me of when I started out. What's your name?
I am Liz.
Liz, what a nice name you have. We'll be charging you $30 a month.
I'll start tomorrow.
Oh, sure.
Master Bruce Lee, he's really smart. I admire him so much.
Master, I'm here.
Oh. It's you, Wong Jackman.
Master, I couldn't stay in Hong Kong.
Where's Wong Li Chao?
He's already dead.
How did he die?
He got sick and died.
A good man. That is such a shame. You studied in Taiwan for 3 years. 3 long years. You trained very hard in Kung Fu.
Master, you know what? I didn't learn one style.
Didn't learn a style? I'm a bit curious. All right, Wong Jackman. Come and show me what you've learned.
But I'd just be humiliated.
Come on, show me already.
It is my honor.
Good.
I have my doubts. If martial arts routines and fixed movements are really important or not. I've had a lot of matches in my life. I've used many different techniques from different martial arts. For example, Yong Chun Chuan, Hong Quan, Karate, and Boxing. What I did was combine them all, except it was hard to tell what dojo and what style the technique originated from. So what I did, in essence, was that I canceled all the movements. Also, I took away all the restrictions, so your heart and soul and mind can express themselves in their own way. So remember, use the easiest, the most straightforward attack possible. Our Kung Fu has a very long and colorful history. Any martial artist of any school believed that he knew the truth. He always tried to defeat all the other styles to prove that his Kung Fu is the best. But I have a different view. The essence of Jin Fan Kung Fu is neither false nor forceful, no style being a style, being limitless as a limitation, going with the flow. Now these thoughts are brought about by my experience from real fights. They make up the essence of our Kung Fu, to adopt the essence of all other styles.
Come on, sit down.
After you. I heard you went to America, became president of the Chinese Martial Arts Association, so I decided to follow you.
I had no choice but to leave for America. What could I do? In Hong Kong, you and Li Chao, you two caused trouble for me. That's when I felt that I couldn't stay there, so I had to leave.
Bruce Lee's fault.
That's in the past now. So tell me, what do you intend to do now?
Me? I want to be the best in the world. I'll fight anyone who challenges me. I'm going to find Bruce Lee and get revenge.
It's a small world indeed. After Bruce Lee came to America, his kung fu improved a lot. In the newspaper, it says an unknown Chinese beat the champion previously undefeated for 3 years, Hoffman. That Bruce Lee, he's so famous now. Even if I'm the president of the Chinese Kung Fu Association, he doesn't respect me. He put up a school in Oakland. He didn't even let me know. He has no regard for the martial arts code.
He put up a school in your area? He disrespected you? How could he do that?
Maybe he thinks I'm old-fashioned. That Bruce Lee probably thinks he's somebody now. And answers to no one.
I'll make him answer to me.
One! Good. Two! Good. And three! Good. From the top. One, two, three! Good. One, two, three! One, two, three! Let's do it again, okay? Now stop! Hold it! Okay, hold that. It's not firm enough. Like this. Try it, come on. Again. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Okay, one more. One. Two.
What Bruce Lee did poses a big problem. He violated the martial arts code. We have received so many complaints from other masters. For so many years, everyone who's put up kung fu houses in America complied. We've all made an agreement that we won't teach foreigners. And for decades, no one has dared break that rule. Then comes Bruce Lee. He enters the California competition and beats the champion, then begins to recruit students. In his kung fu house, most of the students are black and white people. Ha! And also Filipinos and Japanese.
Yes. So everyone expected Master Wang to put a stop to this madness, to tell Lee to stop teaching. And so, he'll abide by the martial arts code, which the whole community is following. We don't teach foreigners.
I've been living here for so long, and I've never met a man as rude or as arrogant as him. He has no respect for us. Master Wang, you're the president of the martial arts community. Has he ever approached you?
Bruce Lee is still very young. And because of that, he doesn't realize that doing certain things have consequences, that they have penalties.
Master Wang, I think you shouldn't have been so easy on him. That boy needs a lesson.
I wouldn't worry about him.
The only way to deal with him is to speak with your fists. Come on. You've fought him before. Yes, I have. I have a score to settle with Bruce Lee. And to be honest, that's the reason I'm here. I want to fight Bruce Lee.
Wait, Wong Jackman. You're not in Hong Kong or Taiwan. Don't do anything that'll get you in trouble. Bruce Lee beat the karate champ of California. That must mean his kung fu is pretty good. So, you better be 100% if you want to beat him. It won't be easy. If he wins, you will lose face.
Don't worry. These past years, I've been training in Taiwan. I trained only for one reason, to one day defeat him. He'll use Wing Chun. I'm ready for that.
I can counter every attack he makes. Except, I think, he's afraid of me.
And if you beat him, what then?
I'll follow the guidelines. He must make an announcement that will be published in the newspaper that he lost to Wong Jakman. And he'll close his kung fu house. Master, what do you think?
I don't know. Let me remind you not to be rash. Let me make the arrangements so that this match will be sanctioned by the community and be duly recognized. That way, he'll have to comply with us.
Fine. You take care of it.
Master Ma, send him an invitation. Tell him it's for me. Invite him for tea.
Attention. One.
Two. Three. One. Two. Three.
Hi, can I help you, gentlemen?
I suppose you are Master Bruce Lee.
That's right. What can I do for you?
Does the president of the California Martial Arts Association, Wang Yunsheng, sound familiar to you?
Yes, what's the problem?
I am the chief aide of the president. He'd like to invite you over for tea, and he hopes you'd accept his invitation.
Yes. Please tell him I'm thankful. Don't worry. I'll be there. This way.
It's an honor to have you here, Mr. Lee. How are you?
I am deeply honored, Master.
This way. Thank you for accepting my invitation. First of all, let me say that I'm glad you beat Hoffman. You did something the Chinese could be proud of. Please, sit down. In the Chinese community, we're proud to have a person as brilliant as you. I'm happy for that. But Bruce, a tree standing outside the woods is taken down by the wind. And what you've done has made a lot of others very jealous. And it is causing a few problems.
Master, what have you been hearing them say?
They asked me to come here to help out some friends. And those are good friends. I manage the Chinese Kung Fu Association of California. And right now, I want you to tell me if what these letters say is true. Do you know what it says? That in Seattle, you ran a little kung fu house and you put up a sign. And it said you teach kung fu.
Yes, Master. All of it is true.
Wait. There's one more thing. There is another matter that I have to confirm.
I think I know. Did I teach foreigners as well?
Yes. I have heard some of your students are not Chinese.
Honestly, sir, in my kung fu house, about 80% are non-Chinese.
And that is the problem. Listen, Bruce, you're not the first to open a kung fu house in America. Many teach martial arts, but no one is doing it like you. For the longest time, all the Chinese here have been abiding by the spoken rule that we only teach Chinese. I'm hoping that you come to your senses. Admit your fault and stop it. I want you to dismiss your non-Chinese students. That way people will stop complaining.
Master, those rules, they are but a hindrance to the development of martial arts. If we truly want kung fu to evolve, those rules have to be broken and never followed.
Let me ask you, Bruce. Have you really given this much thought of what would happen if the non-Chinese learned our secrets?
Isn't karate from Japan? The Japanese brought karate here and taught everyone. There are karate clubs all over America. Over here, there are national and international kung fu competitions.
the Japanese kept it themselves, would karate be so popular here?
I've heard enough. I can't get through to you. Mr. Lee, I tried to go about this the nice way, but it seems to be futile.
I see. It seems, Master, you prepared a Hongmen banquet for Bruce Lee.
Mr. Lee, I speak in behalf of everyone, that you must follow the code. The association has spoken, and you must obey. I really hope that brat would see the error of his ways and stop before it's too late, because we are not going to tolerate it. I demeaned myself by meeting him, only to find out that it was pointless. The nerve of that boy, that Bruce Lee, not only refused to listen to me, he also said it would be better if the rules of the association were abolished. This cannot be tolerated. We've been obediently abiding by those regulations, not to teach foreigners kung fu. How can we just allow him to break all the rules? And so, I invited you all here to discuss how to deal with this. How do you propose we handle the problem?
Handle the problem? I know how. We'll just send him a notice, telling him that what he's doing is a mockery of the martial arts code.
Tell him that he should stop teaching foreigners kung fu. If not, he should close down his school.
Master Wang, Master Ma, I've already done that. He was so arrogant, he still would not comply.
Then we should band together and destroy his kung fu house.
We can't. Doing that will get us in trouble. Even if the police don't find out, we still can't do things that way. There must be another way.
And what do you suggest that we do?
I have an idea. This way we won't get in trouble, and we will make him abide by our rules. Soon.
Okay. Good. That's great. Give it more.
Higher.
Kick higher. Have a kick higher.
Higher.
This? You've come to bring another invitation?
No. The California Kung Fu Association issues you this. It's a challenge to a match.
A challenge?
Yes.
Can you tell me what happens if I accept this challenge? If I refuse the challenge, what happens?
If you accept, naturally, there's a winner and a loser. The loser should obey everything that the winner commands. Now, if you choose not to accept the challenge, you have to abide unconditionally to all the rules set forth by the California Martial Arts Association. You must follow the rules. They're giving you two choices. You must stop teaching kung fu to non-Chinese or close down your school permanently.
Looks like I don't have a choice.
No. I just gave you two.
Fine. Then I accept.
Thank you.
me revenge.
Bruce. This was a big decision. Why didn't you talk to me before you answered them?
Linda, please calm down. I had no choice.
You could have just ignored him if you want to. If they cause trouble, you can report it to the police. Bruce, there's no telling what they might do. Why not just let the police handle it?
Linda, I didn't have a choice. Also, I don't want American police to get involved in this. It would just make me look weak.
But still, you're only human like everyone else. How can you be sure you'd win every time? What if your opponent is stronger, huh? Have you ever thought of what would happen to you then?
Linda, you know me. The outcome is not important.
But Bruce, things are different now. You can't just think about yourself. You also have to think about our unborn child. You have to consider that when you make a decision. Understand?
Linda, could you please listen to me? I'm familiar with these Chinese masters. I've known them for a while. I may not have seen or fought with a lot of them, but I've heard of them. Lately, I've been analyzing most of our rival houses, and do you know what I've come up with? I've seen them. You know what? I saw them fight. Simply put, it's a fair match. It's too close to call. But if Bruce accepts their challenge and has a match with their fighters, he has 90% chance of winning.
It's just I'm scared something bad may happen.
I know what you mean. You're worried that there will always be a new fighter who will challenge him, am I right? But honestly, I don't think there's anyone who can beat Bruce in a fair fight. At least that's what I think. But let's say such a fighter does come along. What if a fighter better than him comes and challenges him? There's only one way. To be sure, nothing goes wrong. And that is for you, Bruce, to let me tell you what to do. In order for you to win, if you listen to my idea, I think it will help you win the match.
What's your idea?
That during your match, you listen to my instructions. That way, even if you might lose the match, you still avoid getting any serious injury.
Uncle Chow, I don't understand what you mean.
According to the rules of the match, as long as one side says he gives up, the other man has to stop attacking him. I know Bruce very well. He's not the kind who'll give up easily. So, the time to stop, or rather, if it's still okay to fight, I think should be my call. Bruce, would you trust me?
You would never have to step in.
I know that. Just in case, if I see you losing in the match, the opponent is still attacking and there's no way you can escape. At that time, I'll throw a white towel on the floor. Once you see that towel, that is a signal for you to stop. We'll stop the match.
Why are you suggesting this?
Because it's important. We're all Chinese, right? Huh? Isn't that what this fight is all about? An internal struggle in the Chinese community? When it comes to injuring people, you or any other person should avoid it as much as possible.
Bruce. Bruce. I think his idea is good. You should follow it. Please. It's the safest choice.
All right. Uncle Chow will do it your way. But I still think you'll never have to throw in that towel.
I really hope so.
Bye. Everyone ready?
All right, get it ready.
This way. This way, please. Gentlemen, this way. All right, please sit. Over here. Please, right over there. Please take your seats. All right. This way, please. Come on. Master Wang, Master Huang, Master Ma.
Mr. Lee.
Wong Jack Man, so it's you. Surprised, aren't you?
Definitely a surprise.
Bruce Lee. I don't care how many Americans or Japanese you've defeated. Because today, you're going to lose to me.
You're nothing but a shadow.
Right. I am your shadow. I will always be following you. So you'll never be rid of me.
Actually, years ago, we had some unfinished business. And today, we're going to settle this once and for all. With all these witnesses. So get ready. Today, I'll show everybody. The world will know that once again, you failed to defeat Bruce Lee in a fight.
Uncle Chow, what are they doing?
You'll understand later.
I'm just worried. I think they've fought each other before.
Linda, take it easy. Have confidence in Bruce.
Come on! Mr. Wan, what were they talking about?
It was about their past.
They know each other?
They know each other very well.
What are you waiting for? Come on!
Remember this, Bruce?
How about up there? First to fall loses, okay?
Sure.
Why did they go up there?
They're trying to outdo each other. They don't want to fight the normal way. They decided to raise the stakes.
It seems this time, Bruce Lee is dealing with an old foe, a rival that's tough to beat. Usually in a fight, they can see each other, but that's not the case on this one. Once they're blindfolded, it's a totally different fight. By listening carefully, they can tell where the other is. For example, when they walk, or when they breathe, or even just the way the other smells. Even the sound their clothes make. All of this will help them figure out how far they are from each other. And if they are truly masters, they'll even sense each other's position. Based on what they feel with their body here, they'll wait for one chance to strike at the other. This kind of fighting can be done by ordinary fighters. It's an extraordinary skill only masters of Kung Fu would know.
Linda, why are you here?
Oh, Kimura, my baby. I think it's coming.
Huh? I have to tell Bruce.
No, don't tell him. He's still fighting, so you mustn't tell him about this.
Linda's giving birth. Take her to the hospital. All right, Bruce Lee. Congratulations. However, I'll only give you 15 days. In 15 days, we finish this!
Sure! Where's Linda?
Please hold on. You're going to be fine.
I'll be a father soon. Isn't that wonderful? It'll be okay.
Nurse, can we go in?
No, sir. You can't go in. You'll have to wait here.
Bruce, we can't go in there. Come, sit down. Bruce, please don't worry. It's just gonna be okay.
Well, of course he's good looking. Let me have a look at him.
Oh. Careful.
Ooh, what a cute, beautiful little boy. So can you say Papa? Wow, you're such a cute little baby. He's 75% you. The rest is me. How are you, little fella? You know, your mother, she's going to adore him. I've decided his Chinese name.
What is it?
Guo Hao.
Guo Hao? That sounds good. What does it mean?
Guo Hao means he will bring pride to the Chinese.
Oh.
Hey. Have you thought of a good English name for him?
I picked Brandon Lee.
Brandon Lee?
Mm-hmm.
Brandon Lee. Hello, Brandon Lee. Here, go back to your mom.
Okay.
I'm sure your grandmother will be so excited to see you. As soon as Daddy defeats Wong Jack Man, we'll take Daddy. You to see Grandma.